Hi friends, 2 days ago, a very interesting article got published in Canada's one of the leading newspaper, Globe and Mail. How Canada learned what's wrong with its immigration system by slamming its border shut. And it is written by international affairs columnist Doug Saunders. And this has invited a lot of discussion over social media, especially with those who have been waiting to live their Canadian dream. Now, I'm sharing the link to this article in the description below. However, since it is a paid subscription, you might not have access to this article. What I'll do is I will try to bring the context, what is written in this article. And I also will be giving my opinion and invite your comment to this article. So he starts the article saying, how do you find 401k immigrants to become new Canadians? This is the target which has been kept for 2021 when nobody is even allowed to enter. Very valid question which all of us had in mind before what happened few weeks back. Even I was thinking that maybe this time the target will not be achieved. This was the puzzle which IRCC faced during the start of year, as Canada had kept target of 1.2 million over next 3 years. That is roughly about 1% of the population every year Canada was planning to add. He mentions that in 2020, the immigration was lowest since 1990s. If you have watched my previous video, I also brought this fact that the last year's intake was almost equivalent or less than 1996. You think how many years we went back because of this COVID-related situation. In fact, many were of the opinion that with pandemic, border closing, this target is not achievable. Then you all know what happened in mid-February. CEC draw with lowest CRS score. He says that solution was surprising and ingenious, but also revealed some of the deep flaw in outdated and overcomplicated immigration system, which was designed for restriction rather than growth. Then he goes on to mention that Immigration Minister Marco Mendicino recognizes that most of the 401k are already living and working in Canada, and they just don't have the right kind of visa and the points. He also brings the fact that the usual invitation, which used to be 3,000 to 5,000, this time was 27,000, which was unheard and unthinkable till the last draw. And he hinted that this rate would continue. In order to invite current resident, the CRS point system was lowered. Now, this is all known, the lowest CRS score of 75. Immigrant who were having long waiting time suddenly learned they were on the pathway to become Canadians. Many were surprised. This is said by an immigration lawyer who says, qualified high quality people were always here. It took a crisis for the government to see it. Another immigration lawyer, he now feels that the target of 400k is possible, as many are already in Canada and it will have repercussion on the way they do things. He goes on to say that it always should have been prioritized for people already living in Canada. He says that it is not the lack of actual skill, but a complex and often self-contradictory set of rule and classification. That is what this immigration lawyer comments. He also says that at the root are 2 decades old assumption behind our immigration system, both of which have been challenged by the pandemic. The first is highly skilled, educated and fluent immigrants are comparative rarity, and lengthy weeding out process is needed to find them. Second, the divide of temporary and permanent high skilled. I will reserve my opinion for the end. I will just continue with reading what is written. Many temporary workers are having post-secondary diploma and degree from their home countries, which is very, very true. If you look at the nurses and some of the caregivers, they have this requirement. Now, the counter view has been provided by a former Director General of Canada's Immigration Department, who says, I don't think COVID-19 provided an opportunity to rethink our immigration policy. Given what we have seen in terms of essential workers, traditionally undervalued and underpaid. He does not believe that government will permanently lower its point score requirement for permanent residency, especially during pandemic recession. The columnist gives his thought that an immigration policy designed for growing, educated policy need to do 3 things. These are, his recommendation: keep family intact, He goes on to describe this in detail. And during pandemic, if you go on social media, you will see that there are many permanent resident as well as citizens whose family have not been able to join because of various reasons. So he brings out that fact. Avoid leaving people stuck in Canada. This point, Canada government has been considering. System should allow rapid movement between categories and classes of immigration, ideally without changing anything. It's a very good suggestion. And he concludes saying, we need to start taking advantage of the immigration asset we already have. Now, my comment on this article, it's a very well written, very well articulated, and I really like the recommendations what the columnist has given. However, with the limitation IRCC had, my personal feeling is that they have done a fantastic job, especially with the last draw. It has, you know, raised hope with many of the candidates who were already in Canada. And I'm sure that, you know, with all the learning, we all are learning, all the learning, in future, we might see that the process gets improved, it's faster, and these barriers which has come over last more than 1 year becomes a tool through which the system gets redesigned and the process is faster. So friends, this is the article which I thought I will share with you. I hope you found this interesting. And if you liked it, please press the like button and do comment as well. Thanks for watching Canada Tried and Tested.